Are you making progress with the writings of the ancient sages?
Yes, dear father. I have thoroughly digested it and have come a step closer to the grid. The desire within me to do evil is defeated.
Really? Excellent. I am proud of you, my child. Continue to concentrate on your studies. I must go to Stonebreeze to clear up a few matters. I'll be back soon. In the meantime, my loyal friend Grimley will protect the country. Should anything trouble you, you can turn to him. Isn't that right, Grimley?
Aye, of course, Janus. I'll keep an eye on the Jumlows. Your daughter. You can count on me.
Then I'll see you soon, my friends. May the goddess watch over you, and the light burn eternally.
By my eyes, dear father, I'll make you so proud of me. Who does good is good.
Yuck. Disgusting phrases like that always leave such a nasty taste in my mouth. These abnormally good heroes, on the other hand, had no inkling of the malignity gathered to the south. One moment, a herd of sheep was peacefully grazing. Next moment, what? With a fulminant explosive effect that ate up half our special effects budget, the shadow entered the world. His target, a dark elf caught between good and evil, was very close. As the shadow of the unspeakably evil evil moved through the world, all around it died. Plants withered. Animals perished. Sort of had a picnic with my family. The shadow of the far-off evil found itself very, very close to Tristram. It could practically feel its target's presence.
Take these lanterns, men, and let the light of the goddess shine. For the night is dark and full of terrors. And there's a pile of horse poo around here somewhere. I trod in it earlier. For the darkness!
Yes, well, that is somewhat suboptimal. Naturally, the shadow of the almighty evil was an incredibly powerful creature. But, well, light was a bit of an issue. It would certainly be wise to stay out of the lantern light. Lanterns! Lanterns everywhere! Lanterns! You'd think some nutcase had them all over the place just to be irritating. I'm supposed to be the evil one here. Whatever. The shadow of the nestled cozily before the fireplace evil was extremely sensitive to light and would inevitably take damage from it. It was important to avoid light as much as possible. To Tristram. Fortunately, this one was not closed, but it was brightly lit. Luckily, there was an unfortunate guard on patrol that the shadow was able to possess, thanks to its incredible powers. As long as it wasn't in the light. The shadow of absolute evil melded with the guard and took control of his body. Thus, it was able to pass through the gate with ease.
What was that? I think there was something wrong with our last beer.
Unfortunately, the shadow's possession only lasted a short while before the guard was able to free himself. Still, it was long enough to get past the gate. The shadow's target was close, so close. Talia, the dark elf. Soon she would fight on the side of evil.
May the goddess be with you, my friends. It will soon be time to open the orphanage in the Fatiguing Library. Come to the big square and join in the festivities.
Well, I don't know. I had actually kind of planned to spend the evening in the bathhouse.
Friends, this orphanage is very important to my father. Talos, you know, the mighty paladin, the one you really don't want to offend.
All right, we'd love to come.
Excellent. May the light of the goddess shine upon you and let us experience this exhilarating spectacle in the big square.
In your face like that, boy. I am Grimwe, King of the Dwarves, and I am used to the cold, dark tunnels under the mountains. I have no need of any stupid lamp shining into my eyes. Now I'm stuck with that dumb, pointy-eared... my good friend Thanos' foster daughter. Cursing. The dark elf is a dark elf, and nothing will change that. The girl will always be tainted. Should have cut her ears off when I had the chance.
As usual for a dwarf, Grimwe was on his best behavior, especially where elves were concerned.
Sit off chit-chat, men. You stay here and secure the area. I have to go check my invention. Stay alert. I can feel something evil.
In the distance, one could hear the unbearably good bells of the church. They must be marking the opening of the orphanage in the Fatiguing Library. Heroes, with lanterns, began to stream in that direction. The crossing on a red signal evil shadow swore, or would have, if it had a mouth, and tried to avoid the lanterns as much as possible.
Into the Fatiguing Library for our goddess!
And
in the name of my father, Talos, I'm glad to see so many of you here of your own free will.
The words literally flowed from Talia's mouth. As the masses listened to her with ever-increasing boredom, excitement, the gruesome evil's confined shadow. Finally, the time had come, and the shadow of the partisan and slow-laying evil was within range of Talia, the dark elf. The time had come for it to use its incredible powers to possess her for a short time.
And destroy it utterly and utterly.
untrusting as he was whistling cheerfully to himself, with no inkling of his foster daughter's dark deeds. Though he was aware that as a dark elf, she always had a core of evil in her. He had hoped to defeat it through religious indoctrination with ancient mad writings. Well, Dean, you thought wrong.